Yep. Again? Okay. Fine. Hungry? Yours. Here. Fine. Okay. Yours. So long.
What? You okay, boy? Again, sir.
Oh, my Lord!
I need a wash. Your bath.
Magnificent. You'll feel renewed.
Thanks, partner.
Anytime you
oh,
want.
Shit!
I ain't stopping till you're dead.
Yep.
Would you like help in there?
Maybe another time.
All right. Suit yourself, sweetheart. What you see? Excuse me, sugar. Careful now.
Just what I need.
How do you do, sir?
Okay, I'll have your best.
You got any rooms?
It's ready for you now. Do enjoy.
Thank you.
There. Good to see you back here, partner.
Listen, we're tired. 14. Place your bets now.
Hey, Mr.
Got a hunch on this.
All right, bet's closed. Shall we?
That's the one. He's a nightmare.
You look like you could relax a bit, huh?
No, gonna stand.
You know, you got the most fasting eyes.
Bets, please.
You're sweeter than pie.
Let's try this out.
Bets are closed. Let's begin.
So.
But I'm lonely, sugar.
I'm standing.
What? You don't like chatting with a pretty girl?
When you got a strong bloodline like the Greys, civilization just springs up around you.
Bet's closed, folks. Let's go.
Turns out a con man hustled the Gordon family out of most of all their inheritance.
Yeah, I heard that too.
Well then, how can I help you?
Can I take the catfish, please? Time to go, boy.
How do you do?
Hey! Over here! Over here! Please, friend. You gotta help me out here. Come on, please. I'm about done here. Found good.
There you go.
Oh! Thank you!
Hello, boy.
Like hell on earth.
You okay, boy?
In the south, in a swamp. This is not for me.
Nor me. But we're alive.
Well, Sean's not. Jenny, Mac, Davy. Folks always die caring. You and me will die. Trick is to enjoy it while you're alive.
That's the trick of it.
Well, I haven't mastered that yet.
You? You have more fun than anyone.
Do I?
Thank you for your help with Miss Jackson.
Don't mention it, Miss Grimshaw.
You're a fine man, Mr. Morgan. Sometimes, at least.
Thank you. I think.
Hey, Arthur.
Mr. Trelawney.
It's been easy for you.
Still.
I thought you'd have hightailed it by now, to be honest.
And go where? This is all I got for now. And you all ain't so bad. Abigail, she's as good as they come.
So everyone keeps telling me.
My dear Arthur, I hope this letter finds you well. I wanted to thank you for your help with Jamie. He and Daddy are still arguing, but I understand that Jamie is thinking about going back to college. Whatever happens, I believe you saved his life and we are all truly grateful. Oh, Arthur, I have made such a mess of my life time and again. Why can I not change and be the woman I want to be? Why couldn't you change and be a man and put down all those fantasies that shroud your judgment? Life is very confusing, and I see now that I am not very good at it. I'm afraid we've got ourselves into another mess. It's not my fault, but I need your help. I'm staying at the Hotel Grand in Saint Denis. Oh, Arthur. I know it is wrong to ask you, but I have nobody else, and for what we once had together, I beg of you, even though I am ashamed to do so. Yours, Mary.
Thank you. friend.
Take a pamphlet. Learn all about our great religion and understand the importance of safety in nature.
What do you need?
Wait there. I'm coming straight down. Arthur.
Hello, Mary.
You came.
Sure. Whenever you call for me, I'll come.
Oh, Arthur.
What's wrong?
Daddy.
Your father? I'm a bigger fool than I even thought.
I'm begging you, Arthur. I know Daddy was not kind to you, but surely you cannot hate a man for the sin of loving his daughter and wanting better for her than
me?
Than the choices you
what
make.
What choice did I have? Did I ever have?
Oh, I know. You had to live by your code. But your code is... well, it's not right.
Has your way been right, Mary? With you? And Jamie joining a bunch of crazies? And hypocritical daddy with his drinking and whoring and gambling? Huh? Is that what a pure life has gotten you? Begging me for help?
Oh, Arthur. Be kind to me. Please.
Sorry.
I am... I should have asked someone else, but...
But I'm the best guy you know at frightening decent people.
It wasn't that I didn't love you, Arthur. You know that.
Mama.
Oh, Arthur. We were so very young. Think how different life could have been.
Yeah, I think about it. A lot. It all seems so long ago and far away now.
Will you help me try to save Daddy? Please. You came all this way. It would really mean a lot.
Come along, then. Where are we going? What's the old lovable patriarch been up to now?
Oh, Arthur, you know sarcasm is beneath you. He's been gambling and drinking and other things.
Oh, the filthy rotter. Where can we find him?
He said he was going down to the Theodore Eckhart stables. Something about a horse. It's down by the water in the warehouse district near the train yard.
Come on, then.
Don't be a pompous ass, Arthur. It doesn't suit you.
Oh, should I leave that to Daddy?
Leave Daddy alone. He suffers enough.
Well, I suppose I can take some consolation in that.
Oh, Arthur. I should have ran away with you years ago.
Well, you wouldn't.
No, I didn't. But... well... I don't know.
So what do you think he's up to?
I'm not sure. He keeps saying it's a disgrace a man of his standing has to ride around on some old nag.
Standing? He's usually falling down.
Arthur. He wasn't always this way. But...
watch out!
It has got worse. He's drinking and gambling more than ever. Pawning things off left and right. Mixing with bad people. I'm just scared for him.
Don't worry.
This is the place. Let me go in and see what kind of a state he's in.
Sure. I'll wait here. Good luck. Scream if you need any help.
Very funny.
You can't stand there.
What, in the street?
Yes, in the street.
Is it your street?
Just get out of here.
Why?
I said, just get out of here.
Listen, partner. I'm waiting on a lady. She's a fine lady. She's just gone inside. If I wasn't waiting on this lady, you'd be dead already. But if you continue to irritate me, I'll kill you. I make my apologies to the lady. It's your call.
Oh, I didn't mean nothing.
Never been so demeaned in my life.
Apology accepted. Oh, wait right there.
I have half a mind to kill you myself.
Daddy.
No.
Oh, Daddy, please, come home. You're tired, Daddy, tired and
I am no such thing. You get away from me. You head home. I insist upon it. Leave me be. Damn nuisance.
Excuse me, partner. Still as charming as ever, I see.
Oh, Arthur, he's up to no good. We better follow him.
Okay.
This way. He went around the corner. Hold on.
You can see why he has such a high opinion of himself. We'll just follow the smell.
Arthur, come on. He just went between those crates. Come here, quick.
Mind where you go. Mind where you go!
Sorry?
Do you think he saw us?
I don't think so.
What did you say to me?
I didn't say a thing insulting.
I'll wipe that goddamn smirk clean off your face.
Ain't you a little old for brawling, mister?
Damn you!
He's heading across the road.
You know, this is kind of fun.
Shh, he'll hear you. You could have cleaned yourself up a bit.
I didn't realize I was here to impress anyone.
He just went left down that alleyway. What's he doing?
Let's go find out. Don't say I never show you a good time.
I'm just glad you're here. Not that way. What's he doing? What do you think he's doing?
Well, he's either waiting for a woman of dubious morals, or he's trying to sell something.
So, Ashton, you got the money?
Seems he's selling something.
Have you got the brooch, Mr. Gillis?
Yes. Here.
Here's the money. That is beautiful.
It's a family heirloom.
That was Mother's brooch.
Not any longer, Mr. Gillis. Enjoy the money, And should you need any more, I can offer you a loan at a very reasonable rate of interest.
No, thank you. I've heard what happens to folks who take loans from you.
It's not even his to sell.
No, it's just a brooch. At least he didn't get himself killed.
You don't understand. Mother left it to me. You sold my mother's brooch? How could you?
You!
That's theft!
Oh, speaking of thieves, I see you found your outlaw again.
Hello, sir. Have you been well?
Daddy, how could you?
Mary, wait here. I'll go get the brooch.
Don't hurt anyone, Arthur.
He'll probably kill someone.
Hey, you, Ashton! Hold her right there! God damn it! Hey! Stop that coach! Get back here! You hearing me? Stop that damn coach! God damn it! You stop right now!
Leave me alone. It's just a brooch.
I want that brooch. It wasn't Gillis's to sell.
I bought it fair and square.
How much do you want for it?
I guess I could give it to you for $100.
$100? What do you take me for?
Okay, okay. I'm a reasonable man. Let's say 50.
Not good enough, Ashton.
Okay, Jesus! $25, that's my final offer.
Here.
Here, take the damn thing. Crazy son of a bitch! You don't know who...
Where's your father?
I don't know.
You want me to go find him again?
Not really.
Well, let's take a walk. I'll take you to the trolley.
Thank you.
Got you your brooch back.
I won't ask.
Probably best not.
Hey. What are you doing now? Right this moment?
Why'd you ask?
Well, I was wondering if you wanted to do something. Head to the theater, perhaps.
Theater? Me? Sure, why not?
It'll be fun, Arthur. Let's go to the Relure. They have the strangest acts.
Strangest I can handle. It's the normal business of life. I can't seem to get a grip on it.
You and me both, Arthur. Oh, I've missed you.
Don't start.
You're an idiot. But you'll always be my friend.
Well, of course I'm your friend, but... You ain't always fair with me.
If I was fair with you and a good person, I'd have had you hanged a long time ago.
Well, that's true.
So, shut up and act like a gentleman, or at least try to for once in your brainless life.
You're not a very nice woman, Mrs. Lynn.
Well, look at the company I keep.
I know, it's quite dreadful, isn't it?
It's sort of beautiful. In a gaudy and tasteless way.
It's the only way I know.
Thank you.
Well, no, I didn't mean it like that.
I'm sure. You silly man. Come on, let's go find our seats.
How about here on the right?
Sure.
After you.
Applause. I am Aldridge T. Abington, the greatest assembler of entertainment since Woo! Nero himself.
This is great.
Do not doubt. As a child, when I walked the horse manure covered streets of Saint-Denis, I never dreamed of the stir I would create in this locality.
Just
as
starting
a proprietor
or not?
Are you in
a
rush?
The greatest
Arthur?
Show ever assembled. Prepare! For the grandest excitement of your curiosity. Fire, snakes, and magic. I encourage any of you to dabble in all three if you have a settled aversion to manual labor as I do. For entertainment is a gift that will see you through the winter better than any packed larder or root cellar full of canned goods. Now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome a truly stunning musical performance to the stage, Miss Robin Koninsky!
Thank you for joining us. Now let's talk a little bit about this place we all love called Saint-Denis.
Bayou swamp and oh, over the sea, we're heading down to Saint-Denis. If your wagon is broke, get to the blacksmith shop. Don't worry yourself with planting a crop. The girls are wearing a brand new gown. We're heading to the Saint-Denis town. Carpetbaggers, coal miners, and mountain folk loosen them stirrups. hopes and let off that yo. Pretty young things say, come with me in the parlors and brothels of Saint Denis. The porter was drinking and the whistle just blew. The trains are heading to the land of voodoo. You won't sleep a wink, I can guarantee. Let's go drinking down in Saint Denis. And poor and the bourgeoisie, they's all heading down to Saint Denis. France didn't really give us much, except wine and grapes and fancy such and such. Pretend to be French, but can't you see? I'd rather live in Saint Denis. Yes, I'd rather live in Saint Denis. So draw your money, come see your honey in old Saint Denis.
Flawless. Perfect. Oh, I see you. You love her dulcet tones, right? Yes, she is pure spectacle, and I assure you she can charm any beast at all, from cockroach to killer whale. Your mother most likely told you not to play with fire or to spend time in the company of strange women. You are about to do both. Miss Antoinette Sansovino.
Stop it. Look at that.
This lady is exotic as all get out.
This is the best. See how this could go horribly wrong.
I hope she stays away from the curtain.
Keep dancing.
Enchanting! Mesmerizing! She is truly one to bring home to mother. It is said that there is a place in France where the naked ladies dance. I have been there. Prepare for the body brassieres of the Petit Flaneur in Gay Paris! Oh, incredible! Aren't they lovely? Oh, those legs are a sight to behold. I am spent. Each of my shows is truly incredulous. Awe-inspiring, and I'm sure you enjoyed. Thank you. We flounder through the morass of humanity, with only bright moments like these, before it all goes dim and snuffs out in silence. So thank you. What a lovely evening. Come back tomorrow.
All right. Well, shall we?
Yes. That was fun, Arthur.
It was.
All right. You better take me to the trolley now, Mr. Morgan.
Of course.
Quite ridiculous, but somehow very amusing.
Sure.
My life wasn't supposed to... Oh. Is it too late for us, Arthur?
I can't lie to you. I'm a wanted man, Mary. If anyone close to me, well, they're wanted to, and I can't have you wrapped up in there. But it's coming to an end. This time it really is.
Run away with me, Arthur. Run away right now and don't look back.
I want to. More than anything I want to. But I've got some people I need to take care of. Once they're free, then I'm free. Then I can disappear.
But Arthur...
If we're gonna run away anywhere, we'd need money. Soon, I'll have some.
I know you won't run away. But it's a pretty dream.
Very pretty. But I will, once I get some money. I had some, but then some fool got it trapped into a town that I can't go back to. That's another story.
I'll write you.
I'll be tending to you shortly. Nothing like a fresh start.
Hello. How can I help?
Good day to you.
Okay, fella.
What do you need?
Thank you.
Please, grab a seat. Well, take a seat and we'll get started. Now that isn't half bad, huh? I say you look ready for a portrait now.
Oh, that's a bit better.
Ladies love a gentleman with a well-groomed mustache.
Hello. How is everything with you?
Say, I'm waiting for things to turn around.
Looking sharper than a tack. All right, you're ready to go. Don't wash it for a day.
Come on, pal.
You got a problem here?
Excuse me. Hey, move!
Hello.
Hello. Good to have you. Everything you need and more in there. You can't beat an expertly put together outfit. So, what do you think? Wearing it out? You can really feel the quality of that one, right? People around here come in just for those. Come now, don't doubt yourself. That looks excellent on you. That is a local favorite. There are a few colors you can go with for this one. My, my, I really think it's perfect for you.
That's it for now.
Anything you'd like to buy?
please bring it over now? We are closing. Thank you for coming in. If there's anything else you need, come on back tomorrow.
Hey, partner.
Parish for that Italian school on recently alighting on our heads.
I see.
Out of the way! Yep, yep. Here. Wait. Let's get. Don't follow me. Yep.
Mister? Days.
Buy me a drink, mon ami, huh?
Nah.
Sure, what you want?
Brandy!
Two brandies, bud.
It's $2 a glass.
Oh, better be good, then.
It's the best.
Thank you. Santé. It's quite a country you're building here, eh?
Well, me personally?
I don't know. What do you do?
Mostly, I just shoot people.
How very American of you. I love it.
What do you do?
Oh, mostly I pose, I show off, I complain.
Oh, how very French.
I know. I am ridiculous. I have been all over the world. I have seen the sights, and I have discovered the one eternal truth that I am a pies, how do you say, all ass.
Asshole?
That too.
Well, at least you have some self-knowledge. Where were you on your journey?
All the civilized world. Painting my little pictures, meeting the locals, you know.
You a painter?
No, I'm a whole ass. I thought we had covered this.
Yeah, but you paint.
Not according to salons at Paris. No, according to them, I cannot draw, I cannot paint, and I should go away. And so I went away.
You miss Paris?
That smelly, filthy place with old buildings and ghosts and shit and French people. I have that right here.
I guess so.
You know,
Arthur.
Charles. You know, Arthur, don't believe in art. It's lies. Believe in women. They are the truth. Art is lies, but the vagina, that is truth. Breasts is truth. Art. For it is.
You say so.
Oh, trust me, I've tried both. One is better. Much better. So, I must be boring you. But here.
What is it?
It's just a little doodle. You know, entirely worthless unless you want to wipe your bottom with it. But I wanted to say thank you for the drinks.
Well, that's very kind, Charles.
No matter.
Good meeting you.
You, kind sir. Will you help the poor?
I ain't so kind.
Yes, you are, sir. You have it in you, I can tell.
I'm a nasty bit of work, father.
You're wrong on two counts, sir. I'm a humble brother, a penitent monk, not a priest, and you're a magnificent bit of work. You may have made some poor choices, but which of us hasn't?
You have no idea.
But you do, and God does, and that's enough for me and for him.
We shall see.
That we shall, sir. But why don't you hedge your bets and give two bits to the poor? There are so many who will go hungry tonight.
Sure.
Bless you, sir.
How you getting on, anyhow?
These are a somewhat apathetic lot, I'm afraid.
My mentor says that America is designed to induce apathy in people.
It's a wonderful insight. He must be a wise man, your mentor.
Well, sometimes he's a downright fool, but, well, usually he's the best man I know.
That's wonderful. The thing is, well, poverty will always be with us. But slavery, I thought we had banished that. Like Saint-Denis is acting as a staging post for shipping slaves out to some of the islands.
I don't believe it. It's 1899.
Maybe you should take a look for yourself. I've heard that the pawnbroker down the block around the corner, the one with the green door, well, they say he sells more than forlorn trinkets. Help the poor.
It's just through the market, there to the left.
Cállate, cállate. Hello? Por favor, ayúdanos. Help, please. Por favor.
Now, don't worry. I'm on your side.
¿Quién eres?
Please, I'm on your side. It's gonna be okay.
Gracias, señor. Muchas gracias.
Come with me. Don't worry. You're gonna be all right now. I promise. That's it. Come on. You'll be safe soon. This way. Not much farther. Poor bastards.
¿Quién es este hombre?
No lo sé. Estamos libres, y eso es lo que importa. Tenemos que confiar en él.
Heard a cattleman drank himself to death.
Welcome back, sir.
Brother.
Brother Dorkin's friend.
Arthur. Arthur Morgan. Come on. You were right. I found these two imprisoned in that shop.
Oh, my. That's... Well, they are blessed to have met you, Arthur.
Trust me in that. They're very unusual. I don't think they speak much English.
My brothers. Come. Let's go get something to eat. Manger. Comida, please.
Hey, you forgot this?
Oh. Yes. Thank you. Here. Payment for your services. I could not have freed these men myself.
Give it to the poor, brother.
Thank you. I will. Like I said, magnificent. Come on. Come. Come see me again sometime. I often work at the old church on Gasper Street in St. Francis.
On the wall there.
You going after Lindsay Waffle?
I might be. Or I might just want to hang his poster up on my wall.
Yeah, they're a bad lot, the Lamone Raiders. Stupid fellas won't leave good enough alone. One of these days, the government's gonna get sick of private militias, you know.
One of these days, the government's gonna get sick of all of us.
Don't tell them I said that.
The bounty. Why are you making this feller someone else's problem?
We, sir, are an urban police force. And the raiders are, well, mostly a rural nuisance. My men simply are not suited for this kind of work.
This feller in particular, Wofford, ain't it? Why him?
You cut off the head, the body dies. That's the hypothesis, at least. We shall see if it can be demonstrated with the Lamoine Raiders.
If the bounty's for this whole outfit, you should have made it more. If that's all, I'll get after him.
If your hand is false, then so be it.
See, you didn't get the message last time. Well, I'll be keeping an eye on you, that's for sure.
Here. Yep, let's get. Yep, yep. Yep.
Good morning, mister.
Hello, sirs.
Morning to you, partner.
Bonjour.
Thank you.
Whoa, easy.
Lindsay Wofford, I got here a warrant for your arrest.
Bastard! What the hell?
Do you do? You
got shit. Quelle folie!
So bad! Why are you doing this?
Cuidado!
You ain't got nothing better to do.
Shit!
The hell?
Hey there, sweetie.
This job gets easier the farther away you are from Saint Denis.
Can't disagree.
I believe this body's worth something.
Well, now. So much for them boys being the care of the South. Drop that raider in the cart out back. Come around for your bounty. Well, that's what there was, and not a penny more.
Looks right. Gentlemen.
Hello? Hi there.
Is that right?
Hello. It'll take more than that, boy.
So how is everything?
Why do I waste my time? Why?
You okay, bud?
Fantastic. You Americans are nothing but shysters and traitors and slippery tongue bull suckers.
I'm inclined to agree.
Here, help me, please. Back to work with a bloody smile. No problem, Marco. You are the great genius, so we shove the hot poker up the ass. Say thank you, Marco.
Thank you. Oh, thank you.
What are you, some kind of European toy maker?
No, I am a fucking genius with poker up the ass, like I say. Toy maker. Hello?
Do I look like I should entertain children?
No.
No, he says. No.
I am the savior of the mankind, buddy.
Yes, you meet him.
Professor Marko Dragic. The one the silver tongue American betrayed and not paid the money to. Yes, he told to shit, man.
So, what's this toy about?
It is not a toy, Big Nuts. It is demonstration of my genius, of my ideas about the source of life.
Oh, it's a toy boat.
Yes, it is a toy boat that I can power remotely using electricity in ways you cannot see.
Good for you. Ways I cannot see.
And still the investors will not come. Just a couple of old ladies and a moron.
Ladies, please.
Ladies! Gentlemen! Enchanté! Hello! Hello, sir! Okay, how is the piles? Yeah? Good, good, good. Okay, my friends, you are about to witness history. A demonstration of my infinite insight. All of us, we feel old. You are old. Oh. But maybe I can make you immortal. Using waves you cannot see. I will power this boat.
You're a goddamn fraud. And this buffoon dressed up like a buffoon is a stoolie. I watch them conspire, you morons.
What? I never met this buffoon before 2 minutes ago. Isn't that right?
Which part of it?
So, Professor, show us your magical toy boat. Only this time let the buffoon control it. Check if there's any funny business.
Oh, this ain't nothing to do with me.
Come, please, please. It is easy. Any moron could do it, and I am about to prove that. Here, take this, and this, and... don't touch that. Use these ones to steer, and this one to shoot torpedoes, okay? Yes, now blow up the little battleships, and avoid the sea mines. They have magnets attached. Make a nasty explosion if they touch the boat. Okay! If this silly dimwit can use torpedoes on boat to destroy the battleships, imagine what technology can do in the hands of certified genius! And I have certificate.
Hey, it's doing what I'm telling it.
Of course it is doing. Now tell it to do closer to battleship and shoot with torpedo. See what he does? No wire like telegraph. No pulley system underwater. Only waves in the air.
This is remarkable. Think of those poor boys on the HL. Eight perished to a mere five on the Housatonic. And what a way to go. Trapped in a box at the bottom of the bay. I suppose you intend to make an unmanned killing machine?
You misunderstand. This is the secret to life. Not death.
There, I'm gone for you.
Yes, you see what he does? Now, bring the boat back to the dock.
That sure was something, but I'm not sure what, if anything, was proven here.
The demonstration's not over yet. Any fool can explode a sitting dock. Let me just reload her.
This is really remarkable.
This is just a demonstration of my prowess, sir. The real miracles require investment. Now the dimwit will use invisible waves to destroy the little sailing boats before they get to other side of pond, still avoiding magnetic mines.
Oh, he'll attempt to, at least.
Shush! You're not here for the smart talk. The steam train, the telegraph machine, the motor car. They all seem pedestrian in comparison to this technology. We are not reliant on wires, or coal, or gasoline. No, just rays in the air, like the voice of God. Let me just reload her.
This is really remarkable.
This is just a demonstration of my prowess, sir. The real miracles require investment. Now, the dimwit will use invisible waves to destroy the little sailing boats before they get to other side of pond, still avoiding magnetic mines.
Oh, he'll attempt to at least.
Shush! You're not here for this smart talk. The steam train, the telegraph machine, the motor car. They will all seem pedestrian in comparison to this technology. We are not reliant on wires or coal or gasoline. No.
Look who rules the seas.
Very good. Very good. Now bring in the boat back here. Foolproof. Undeniably foolproof. But you are not fools. And unlike fools, not fools and their money are difficultly...
As I say, any fool, huh? Thank you, thank you.
What is that?
It is the stuff of life, sir.
It's incredible.
No. Incredible things are in my lab, back at Dover Hill. That will astound all of you. Mr. Marcel, can I count on your support?
Well, this is expensive.
It is immortality, sir. It is very cheap. Perhaps over lunch.
Maybe.
I'm gonna go.
Oh, yeah, of course. And thank you. If you're ever up near Dover Hill, pay me a visit. There, I will really amaze you. I hope you will forgive my...
For a minute of your time?
All right.
Nice to see you again, sir. Did you change your mind about donating by any chance? We could really use your support to improve the lives of our veterans and their families.
$20 ain't no chicken feed, but sure, I can help you out.
That's very kind. What is your name, sir?
Arthur Morgan.
Your donation will be acknowledged on a founder's plaque when the building is completed. You have a great day, Mr. Morgan.
Howdy, partner.
Hey, boy.
Hello. How are you today?
Favor. It's warm. W, an upside down M.
I don't get it.
Oh, you will. It's like swimming. It takes time. But then it's easy. And the whole world opens to you.
I hate this. It's too hard.
Take your time.
Hello, mister.
Sister, my friend, Mr. Morgan.
Oh, sir. Brother Dorkings told me about the wonderful thing you did.
Oh, he talks a lot of nonsense. No offense.
None taken. None taken at all. Hey! Stop!
These kids are the worst!
Don't hurt him, please!
We'll be at the cathedral.
Oh, no! My mother gave me
You all right?
Oh, I'll live.
Kid did this?
You know him?
He robbed me. Which way you go?
That way. Thank
you. Thank you.
Get off me!
Where's my watch, you little weasel?
I don't know nothing about no damn watch.
Last Saturday, I saw you steal it with my own two eyes.
Hey, you. Why don't you leave the boy alone?
What's it to do with you?
I can hit a lot harder than you. I promise you that.
All right, forget it. Little shit ain't even worth my time.
Thanks, mister. Hey, you want some company, mister?
No.
You sure?
Hey.
What?
I don't know you. Mrs. Downs?
Oh, no. Not you. Get away.
How?
Now.
I mean, hey.
Help. Help.
Hold on.
This man is bothering
now.
Me. Someone help me. Officer, help.
What the hell kind of crazy business is this?
Thank you.
solve problems, I don't think they meant you.
How instead of why? Often, the people that are most in need of our help are the most resistant to it.
But that's not a reason to give up on them. No, much the opposite.
If we seek gratitude and recognition, that allows will and our own needs. Mr. Morgan!
Excuse me, Father. Sister, I got your cross.
You didn't!
Oh, I did.
Oh, I hope the boy...
He's fine, physically. Mentally, he's a piece of work, but who am I to say?
Brother Dorkins was right about you. You are the most wonderful man.
Brother Dorkins is greatly deceived, I'm afraid, but I'm happy to help a little.
Thank you. You see, it's a thing, but my mother gave it to me when I was a novice. Shortly before she passed, you are the most wonderful man.
Oh, excuse me, Father. Sister, enjoy your day.
See, Father?
Brother Dorkins chose him.